This is a quick tutorial that will help you make a fun, scenic, animated story for the holidays. Great way to get your class involved in some tech, or just if you want to be creative yourself. We'll go through all of these steps to make it as quick and easy for you and enjoyable as possible. Okay, let's start out with our background sky. Here is the slide over here in format. I'll go down to advanced gradient fill. It remembers a previous color that I've done, which is actually pretty close to what we want. But for the purposes of this, let me show you how to get rid of the colors, because you probably won't have the colors you want. Just to start off with, let's choose some brighter colors to make this more of a daytime scene. Maybe if I go over here, add another color, a little darker, make it going into evening perhaps. How about that? I can slide them all over, gives me a different gradient. Here we go. The more I move it over, see it's getting a little darker there. If I go in between, I can make the gradient a little more subtle. So we've got our background. Step one taken care of. Up here in shape, there's draw with pen. Every time I tap, I put a line in, a little point on a shape that I'm making. I want to make it a shape and not a line, because then the color fills in the way I like. Click on this and it's closed. Double tap anywhere, because as you know, snow doesn't make angled lines, they're slopes. Enter and it's done. Maybe bring it a little lower. Once again, for this object, let's go advanced gradient fill. Same color, which we don't like. Get rid of this, get rid of this. Get rid of all of them except for two. Now, I want on this one over here. That's not very snowy. I'm gonna go with white. That white and blue is kind of nice. Could you go with that? Or I could go over here and try a bit of a silver. Maybe get a little bit of silver blue mixed. What do you think of that? Not bad. If I go over here, I can make it radial. And then I can swap it around so it looks more like this. Move this around, a little more blue, a little less blue. There we go, I like it. So now that's step two, we got our background ready to go. In shapes over here, I can just grab a simple triangle, make it green. I don't really much like that green. Click over here and go with a darker green for a Christmas tree type shape. And now I can just duplicate that if I want, make it bigger, duplicate it again, drag it down, make it bigger, and you've got yourself a pretty standard type Christmas tree. Shift click on all of them, Command Option G, groups them. Now I've got myself a tree. I can get another shape, a rectangle. Go to color over here, make it a nice brown, send it backward. If you don't have all these up here, there's a tutorial at the end which will show you how you can customize your toolbar. Otherwise, in Arrange, you can go over here and you can make it go front or back or slightly backwards or forwards, like so. Over here, use the lines to make it directly in the center. Shift click again, Command Option G. I got myself a Christmas tree. If you look over here, the proportions aren't constrained. So this is actually good. I can make some, Command D duplicates that. I can make some that are taller, some that are fatter. I can send that to the back, so it's on the other side over here. And you can just make all kinds of these things. Just duplicate them, dump them wherever you want. If you wanted to, you'd probably go up over here and even find your own tree. I like it to make them all my own. Change that style to green if you'd like. So there we go, we have our background, we got some trees. I can add more if I like. All right, snowman. We get a circle and back to advanced gradient fill. Now here's a super pro tip for you. Grab this initial shape in style, we can save that. If I can grab this and make it exactly the same. I might want to make that a little larger, a little more oblong, a snowman. Just Command D, make another one. Once again, just using some duplications so we don't have to continue making everything again and again. Backward, Command D, backward, backward. Shift click, Command Option G groups it. The basis of a snowman, shape, circle. This one I'm going to make black. In format arrange, I can constrain the proportions to make sure that it stays a circle no matter what size it is, which is perfect for an eyeball. Command D duplicate. We can go really simply over here, style orange, and in arrange, I can also type in 90 to make it a 90 degree angle, or I can flip it around as I like. I can change the proportionality of it. On with my consistency, I can add a line to it. We see how we end up getting ourselves more and more. Command D, like a snowman. Command D, just moving things around. Command D, just moving things around. I can click and drag and grab everything. Shift click to unselect this. Command Option G groups that I now have this fella here. Let's zoom in a bit. And let's be more creative. Let's make some arms. Draw with pen, not a line, but a shape. Don't worry too much how perfect this is, because once it's all said and done, you can change it up again as well. Close it here. Boom. Enter. Go to fill. Color fill. Black could work. Or you go with a brown, like so. Command D. Over here, flip horizontal. Or over here, format arrange. There's also another option over here to flip horizontally. Leave this one here. Or leave this one here. Maybe I'll send this one a little bit to the back. Shift click. Shift click, Command Option G. Now I have myself a snowman. Now I can make my snowman do things if I would like to. For example, select this guy, format to animate, and have him just move in if we like so. We can make that happen more slowly if we want. Then we can add text. I'm sure you can see now how maybe kids in your class, your own children, or maybe even just yourself, you want to make your own animated Christmas message or season's greetings, whatever you like. There is a tutorial at the end that will tell you how to do this. I've got all kinds of different downloaded fonts. For example, I've got a Christmas font. Right now I'm just holding down Command Plus to make the size of my font larger. If I select it in format text, I could also go like so, or I could even just go right in here and type in numbers. And I want it to stand out a bit. So in style, I'm gonna add a drop shadow and I'm gonna change it to white. And then I'm gonna make it a little more blurry, way more offset, and less opaque. Why don't I animate this as well? So go from format to animate. The build-in for this one, I don't know, play around, find one that you really like. And now, if I were to go to rehearse, I can see what it looks like. Okay, every time I press a button, an animation occurs. Merry Christmas. Or you can go much further. For example, I can take this guy and add an action. Go to shape, once again with the pen. I'm going to choose to have this guy tap, tap, do a bit of a dance here. Tap, tap, that means it's closed. Now I can make all these rounded, so it's more of a dance. Now, cool thing here, really pro tip, select this guy, shift click on this line I've just drawn. Up here in format, shapes and lines, I can make a motion path from this shape. Click on this, and it's done. So now I go to this guy, go to build order. Let's see this move. Let's preview it. Pretty fast. Let's make it much slower. Preview it. Dancing snowman, I like it. And now, I can also go in here. If I delete this, you'll find that it still works and it looks much better. So there you have it. You've made yourself a little animated message. Over here, move in, I can have this happen on click. I like it that way. This will come in. I can make it automatic after build one, and maybe I'll have it wait, I don't know, 2 seconds, is that too long? Now, one thing I notice is, go back here, I don't want this to go behind this text, so I'm gonna go over here and bring them to the front. Again, if you haven't gone to that step at the end and watch the video showing you how to customize your toolbar in format, you can also change it to the front over here. Last pro tip for you, let's add a song. So I'm in document audio, document, document, document audio, command tab to my finder. Here's a song I like, it's very Christmassy. Click and drag that in here, back to this. Okay, let's see how this goes. Animate, build order. Move in happens on click. Let's change that to after transition. Merry Christmas happens after that build. And I think that is too long. Let's not make it wait that long. All right, let's give it a go. There is another video at the end that shows you how to do this in a little bit more detail. You want to add like a cabin to it. You want to draw a hat.